So I started studying physics here at the University of Antwerp, and during my master thesis, I investigated organic molecules for solar cells. I continued to do a PhD on that research topic, but during my PhD, I decided to shift my research topic towards carbon nanotubes. At that moment, carbon nanotubes were very new to the group, and they are very promising materials, but no one knew exactly how to handle them, how to process them, and how to characterize them. So after my PhD, I continued to doing a postdoc here at the University of Antwerp. And I also did research stays in the University of Bordeaux and in Los Alamos National Laboratory, where I co-developed a sorting method for carbon nanotube separations. So in my free time, I play a lot of music. I play the drums, and I'm also a musical director of a youth orchestra with kids between the ages of 8 and 12 years old, which each Saturday come together to play. It's a lot of fun to see these kids grow in their musical talents, and it gives me a lot of joy and energy. At the end of 2015, I received a starting grant from the European Research Council, which allowed me to start up my own research team around these carbon nanotubes. And the project is entitled Order in One Dimension. So we are trying to exploit the hollow core of the nanotubes for encapsulating molecules inside and create unique order. So carbon nanotubes can be best visualized by taking a sheet of graphene. So in a graphene sheet, all carbon atoms are arranged in a hexagonal pattern, with on each of the edges you have a carbon atom. And now if we take this sheet of graphene and we roll it up into a cylinder, then we get our carbon nanotubes. Now the way we roll up the graphene sheet can be done in very different ways, ending up with nanotubes with different diameter, for example, but we can also do it in different orientations. For example, like this. And if we roll it up in different ways, each and every of these different carbon nanotubes will have different properties. For example, they can be semiconducting or metallic in nature, but they can also, each nanotube will also emit and absorb light at a different wavelength. And because of that, we can use optical spectroscopy to identify each chiral structure present in a specific sample. So this is a macroscopic example of such a tubular structure, and as you can see, it is hollow on the inside. And so in my research, I try to encapsulate different molecules inside this tubular structure. And the reason to do that is that the size of the diameter is of the order of the size of the molecules. So in this way, we can actually create a one-dimensional row of molecules. And such one-dimensional rows can have very different properties than when you put those molecules in a bulk material. And I can best explain this by using these magnetic bars, which in a macroscopic sample, they would just align anti-parallel with each other. But if we put them inside the nanotube, we can put them in this orientation very easily. But in the other orientation, they will repel each other and the molecule will not be able to enter the nanotube. The other thing we are focusing on a lot is in separation of carbon nanotubes. So normally, if carbon nanotubes are produced, they come as this black powder form. So the first thing we do with them is we solubilize them, we make them soluble, so that we get these black colored solutions. But these solutions contain a lot of different chiral structures. And so in the end, to go to applications, you want to have just one specific type of nanotube. And so by chemical techniques, we are able to sort the nanotubes and hence get colored solutions, each of these solutions containing just one specific type of carbon nanotubes. In the future, I would like to bridge the gap between our fundamental research and the applications for these nanotubes. And one way of doing that is to focus on this sorting. If we can do this on a very large scale, we will be able to bridge this gap. And for example, bring our filled nanotubes, embed them into solar cells.